Yes, Lardos, it's Svengoolie again with a few suggestions for all you hefty bags out there on how to lose that unwanted surplus of blubber without selling it to your neighborhood Eskimo. Tonight's weight loss tips come to us from the famous Dr. Maxwell Shrillman, author of these famous diet booklets right here. First of all, his first book, Weight Till the Fat Fries, Nelly. Wait, you get it, huh? Like that, of course. His next hit, The Doctor's Quick Weight Loss Through Death. Do remember that. And his latest book, a combination mystery and diet book called I Lost My Lard at Scotland Yard. It's a heavy book. Now, here is the first of Dr. Shrillman's tips. When you feel the urge to overeat, he goes on, just repeat out loud over and over the following phrase. I'm not hungry. I'm not hungry. I'm not hungry. Now, I myself was tempted to try this method of dieting, but it didn't work.
How come?
Well, because I can't talk with my mouth full. That's all.
So much for you.
Okay, now, here is the very latest diet fad that's sweeping the nation, the Tarzan diet. It's called the Tarzan diet because each day for a week, you drink tiger's milk and you're guaranteed to lose 20 pounds.
Wait a minute. How does tiger's milk help you lose 20 pounds?
Well, you try taking it away from a tiger, you'll lose 20 pounds too. Okay. Here is tonight's final dieting hint from Dr. Shrillman. If you can lose 10 pounds each week, and then allow yourself to gain 2 pounds each weekend, in about 1 year, you'll disappear completely. Hey, that's not a bad idea. See you later. Ladies and gentlemen, in an attempt to add a touch of class to tonight's otherwise lackluster show, I've decided to interview the only person with the wit, the charm, the intelligence equal to my own, not to mention the good looks.
Well, don't mention it.
I won't. So here he is for a brief, in-depth, intellectual discussion of the burning questions of the day. Let's give me a warm welcome. Here I am, the one and only, the lovely, the talented Svengoolie. Let's welcome Sven. Come right in. Sit down here, relax. Well, listen. Thank you, really. I couldn't have said that better myself.
You will. Listen, remember, I the interviewer and I the interviewee.
You know, Sven, may I call you Sven?
Go ahead.
Okay. I've always been a big fan of your singing. Tell me, exactly to what do you attribute your musical success? Would you tell me?
Well, dummy, may I call you dummy?
I wish you wouldn't.
Fine. Well, dummy, I attribute my musical success to the millions of tone-deaf people all over America.
Listen, Sven, as far as I'm concerned...
How far is that?
About a block and a half. You go down the street...
Listen, go ahead. You were about to say something nice about
yes,
me.
Yes, I think you're the greatest musical talent since Johnny Tillotson. When I found out you were going to be on the show, I was beside myself.
Huh? Don't look now, but you still are.
That's right. Not only that, but I see now you're better looking in person, really. You know that?
Listen, you said this would be an in-depth interview. So far, there's only one thing that's getting deep in here.
Okay. Now listen, where do you stand?
I'm not standing. I'm sitting.
Will you stop going for the cheap jokes?
Me go for cheap jokes?
Yes. How about you? I've seen this show, and some of the stuff you do is really bad.
Calm down. After all, you got an image to protect, you know? My image? Yes. How about your image?
How about
it? Kidding?
I'm a one-of-a-kind personality.
That's what you think.
Well, we're almost out of time. I want to apologize if I offended you in any way.
That's all right. You know what they say. Yes. You're only hurting yourself.
I said that. Okay, listen. Thank you for coming on my show. And I
what do you mean, your show? It's my show.
No, it's your show. Remember, I asked the question.
Yeah? Well, I just want to say this.
Listen, I don't want you to come into my program.
Look at my
kids,
chicken.
Sit on my elbow again.
And look at the broad chasing profession.